When the film starts, we have Srikant Joshi, age around 62, charming, witty, so full of life, and he easily looms large over everybody around him. But something about his own childhood, his marriage, his memories, his job, everything is somewhere going severely awry, and that is because it's the onset of Alzheimer's disease, that slow killer of all memories. This is pretty much our entry into the world of Srikant Joshi, world of fading memories, and the emotional roller coaster ride that the entire family goes through. And all these are always connected with the very unseen, mute, subterranean, tenuous bonds of love and longing that the entire family shows and does not show. However, in the middle of all these, in the degeneration of his Alzheimer's, one fine day when Srikant Joshi gets lost, that is pretty much the turning point of the film, especially in the relationship that we see between him and his son. So why does son Avinash maintain that his father Srikant Joshi never ever loved him? Where was Joshi for all those 4 years when he couldn't have gotten lost due to Alzheimer's? The solitary mango tree in the ancestral land that he values so much, or the favorite sunset point which he still loves to be taken to, what do they now mean to him? What until recently seemed solid fact is melting into surreal dreams and imaginings that he always thought were so real in a different way? Is there anything he'll be able to salvage from this wreckage? Maybe nothing at all. Or perhaps memories of beauty, the sight of sunset, and perhaps memories of love.